Hey everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to learn how to create dropdown lists in Excel. Let's drop in. Here I am in Microsoft Excel. I'm pulling together a cookie order form for the Kevin Cookie Company. And for the cookie type, I would like customers to be able to choose from a predefined list of cookies. And I think a dropdown list would work perfectly for this. To insert a dropdown list, click into the cell where you would like the list to appear. In my case, it's cell D10. Then, up on the top tabs, go over to the option titled Data. Within the Data ribbon, there's a category for Data Tools. Navigate over there, and here you'll see an icon for Data Validation. Let's click on this. This opens up the Data Validation dialog, and currently, cell D10 is set to allow any value. But we don't just want customers typing in any type of cookie. Let's click on this dropdown list and let's select the item titled list. Right down below, we can define the source for the list, or basically all the different items that appear in the dropdown list. I'll type in all the different cookies that we offer here: chocolate chip, oatmeal, raisin, snickerdoodle, and fortune. One thing you'll notice, insert a comma between each item of your dropdown list. Once you're all done entering in all the different options for your dropdown list, down below, let's click on OK. And look at that, we now have a new dropdown list. With cell D10 selected, over here I have my dropdown list icon, and when I click on that, here I can see all the different items in my dropdown list. Now, let's say that maybe you want to add a new cookie, or maybe you want to remove a cookie. Maybe fortune's not really that popular. Simply click into the cell with your dropdown list, and then go right back up to Data Validation. This again opens up the prompt, and right here I see all the different cookies in my dropdown list. I'll go all the way to the end, insert a comma, a space, and let me add the double chocolate chunk, one of our new cookies here. I'll click on OK, and now when I click on the dropdown right here, we can see the addition of the new cookie, the double chocolate chunk. When I click out of cell D10, you'll notice the dropdown list icon disappears. Of course, if I click back in, it reappears. Sometimes it's not always obvious to users that there's a dropdown list here and they can make a selection. Formatting can help. With cell D10 selected, let's go up to the Home tab. And over here, let's click on the fill icon. I'll click on this and maybe let's apply a light gray background in this cell. And right up on top, I could also apply a border on the outside of this cell. That way users know that they need to click in here and make some type of selection in this cell. As a quick aside, I would also like to format these other cells the same way that I formatted this cell. That way users know that they also need to fill in this information. Of course, I could select one of these cells and I could go up and I could apply the fill color and the border. But instead, Excel has something called the Format Painter, which allows you to take this formatting and apply it anywhere else. With this cell selected, up on the top home ribbon, let's click on the Format Painter. That'll copy all of the formatting. Now I could click into any other cell and it'll paste the formatting. So right over here, I'll click on the customer name and that pastes it. Now I would also like that same formatting down here next to the quantity and the delivery method. Now of course I could go back up, copy the formatting and paste the formatting, but here's an even easier way. With this cell selected, let's double click on the Format Painter. That's now copied the formatting, but now I could click into this cell, and that keeps pasting the formatting until I'm all done. Once you're finished, press the Escape key, and that exits out of the Format Painter. I'd also like to insert a dropdown list for the delivery method, but I already have a worksheet with all of my delivery methods here at the Kevin Cookie Company, so I don't want to have to type all of these in again. Instead, you can also reference cells in your dropdown list. I'll select cell D14 for the delivery method. Then let's go up to Data, and here too, let's click on Data Validation. Just like we did before, let's go down and here let's select List. Now, instead of typing in each individual value on this list, let's click on this icon. And this now allows us to reference different cells in our workbook. I'll go to the Delivery Methods sheet, and over here, I'll select all the different delivery methods that we offer. Over here, you'll see the formula. Here it references delivery methods. That's the name of this worksheet. And then we're specifying the exact cells that we would like to use as part of this dropdown list. Once you're done selecting, click on this icon. There we see, looks good. Let's click on OK. If we now go down, let's click on the dropdown arrow next to delivery methods. And here we see those three different delivery methods. So many people seem to think that the Kevin Cookie Company is a commodity business, but it turns out that we prize innovation. We recently developed a new delivery method called the Cookie Cannon. In case you're wondering, there is a patent pending, and I'd like to add that to my list. Let's click on delivery methods, and down here at the bottom of the list, I'll type in the cookie cannon, let's hit enter, and let's go back to the cookie order form. Down below, let's now see if it shows up in the list. And it does not. So how do we get this included in the list? Let's jump back over to delivery methods to see if we could fix this. A regular list like this does not automatically expand if you add new items or contract when you remove old items. Especially if you're adding and removing often, this next tip will help you save so much time. Let's click our cursor into the data here, and first we're going to turn this into a table. Up on the top tabs, let's click on insert, and here we see the option to insert a table. But when I hover over it, you'll also see that there's a shortcut key, control together with T. Let's press that, and here we have the option to create a table. My table has headers. I'll make sure this box is checked, and then let's click on OK. Now that we've inserted a table, we need to name this column of data in the table. That way, in our dropdown list, we can reference the name of this column. So how do we do that? Well, first off, make sure to select this entire column. Then go up to the Formulas tab. And right in the center, there's a category for defined names. And we can create a new name based on the selection. Let's click on this. And over here, it says create names from values in the top row. I want the name to be delivery method. And then underneath that, we'll have all the different values. Let's click on OK. We've now created a named range. Right up on top, we can click on the name manager. And here we can see that we've created a new name called the delivery method, and we can see all the different values within that name. Here we have the squirrels, the drones, and the catapult. This looks good. Let's click on close. Let's now go back to the cookie order form. Let's now click into delivery method into cell D14. Then up on top, let's click into data. And over here, let's go back into data validation. Let's go down to the source and let's delete what's currently here. Again, this is just looking at this fixed set of cells. I'll press the backspace key to delete that. And now you can enter in the named range. And I believe it was delivery underscore method, but I can't quite remember. As a quick trick, you can press the F3 key on your keyboard, and this opens up all of your different named ranges. And there it is, delivery method. I'll click on this, click on OK, and that inserts the named range as the source for this dropdown list. Now let's click on OK. And let's test it out just to make sure it's still working. I can click on the dropdown list, and there we have all four options. Here comes the real test though. Let's add another item to that table. Let's go back to delivery methods. Right up above, I'll type in another delivery method, the balloon drop delivery. It's a really good one. It's very gentle on the cookie. Over here, let's click back into the cookie order form, and let's click on the dropdown list, and look at that. It's automatically included as part of this list. That's really cool. I'd like to include one more dropdown list for the quantity. I'll click into the cell, and just like we've been doing throughout this whole video, let's go back to data validation. Within the data validation dialog, let's click on this and let's select list. And let's put in a few different options that people can select. 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Then let's click on OK. I want customers to be able to choose from one of these items, but I also want them to be able to type in another number. Maybe they want to order 10 or 20. I don't want my dropdown list to include all possible options. So let's test it out. Let's enter in a 6. When I do that though, I get an error message. Let's cancel out of that. Let's see how we could fix that. Let's select this cell and then let's go up to data validation. Within data validation, let's click on this tab for error alert. And right up on top, it says show an error after invalid data is entered. Basically, as it is right now, if someone enters a value other than 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, they'll get an error message. However, I want people to also be able to write in their own option. So over here, I'll deselect this box. Let's click on OK. Now, I can select an item from this dropdown list, or I could also type in my own value, like let's say a 6, and that works perfectly fine. And that's how you make dropdown lists in Excel. But wait, what if you want a dropdown list where one list changes based on another? Like, let's say you choose chocolate chip in one list, and then you want to choose the type of chocolate chip, like let's say milk, dark, or white. Well, I've got a video for that, and you can click on it right there. Also, drop a comment down below. What's the best or weirdest delivery method that you can think of? The Kevin Cookie Company R&D team requested this. If you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing, and I will see you in the next one.